8 November 2021 Morning Murli Am Shanti BapDada Madhupan Sweet Children, after belonging to shivbaba, don't make any mistakes. By making mistakes, you defame the father's knee. Question: Who has the biggest family and how? Answer: shivbaba's family is the biggest family. On the path of devotion, everyone sings out loud, "You are the mother and you are the father." Therefore, he is a family person, but he doesn't have a family until he enters the corporeal form. Because souls stay up above with the father in the incorporeal form. It is when he enters this one in the corporeal form that he has the biggest family. Om Shanti. Neither Bharat in particular nor the world in general knows whether the father belongs to the path of isolation or to the family path. When the father comes, he calls you, children, children, because you call out to him, you are the mother and you are the father. This makes him a family person. Everyone there knows Shiv is incorporeal, although Shiv has a form. He doesn't have children. If he has, then all souls are his children. All children are the same, and so people think all are God. A soul is a point, and the Supreme Soul is also a point. Householders sing, "You are the mother and you are the father." Sannyasis who belong to the path of isolation say that God is Brahma. They do not say, "You are the mother and you are the father." Their path is separate. They make a mistake by going and singing the praise, "You are the mother and you are the father," in front of Lakshmi and Narayan. Or they sing other praise. They sing a lot of praise on the path of devotion. In fact, God is the father, and so what inheritance do you receive from him and how? Your children know he is the father and he is also the grandfather, means Dada. This one means Brahma is the senior mother and also Prajapita, the father of people. He says through this one, "Children, I am your father and I too have to come onto the family path. This one is my wife and also my child. When I entered this one, I became a family person. I am called the Supreme Father, the Supreme Teacher, and the Supreme Guru. A guru guides you to liberation. All of those are false, whereas this one is the truth." In English, God is called the truth. So, what truth does the truth come and tell you? No one knows this. Even you and I didn't know this. This is something new. The ocean of knowledge is the one who establishes the land of truth. He definitely must have told you the truth at some point, which is why there is such praise. The land of truth is called heaven. They show the deity sovereignty there. It is now the old world and it will then become the new world. The old world is to be set on fire. Destruction is also remembered at the time of establishment. God is remembered as Karan Karavan Har. He carries out establishment through Brahma. How does he get that done? He himself comes and tells you, "People don't know anything at all. They say God is Karan Karavan Har." Now you also know the drama. Only the confluence of the end of the Iron Age and the beginning of the Golden Age should be considered to be elevated. After the Iron Age, there is the Golden Age and then you come down. Heaven and hell are remembered. When someone dies, people say he has become a resident of heaven. Certainly, you must have become residents of heaven at some point. It is the people of Bharat in particular who say this because you know Bharat is the most ancient land of all. Therefore,
this must surely have been heaven. Thus things are so easy. However, according to the drama, they don't understand anything, and this is why the father comes to explain to you. They call out, "Oh, Baba, come. Come and give us knowledge that you have. Come and purify the impure." Then they say, "Remove our sorrow and grant us happiness." However, they don't know what knowledge or happiness he can give. You children now know he is the father, and so creation must definitely have taken place through the father. Father means creator. When children say father, it means they are the creation. Definitely, the creation must also have been created from somewhere, and children would then have been given the property. This is something common, and this is why you sing to me. You are the mother and you are the father. Therefore, Baba is the big householder. You call out, "Oh, mother and father, come. Come and purify us." There is the father, but how can creation take place without a mother? How does Baba create this creation here? This is something completely new. Here too, this doesn't stay in the intellects of many. In other places, they call the Supreme Soul the Father. Here, he is both the mother and father, and so that makes this the family path. There, they simply call him the father, and so they receive the inheritance of liberation. They come later. All of you know that before Christianity, there was the Buddhist religion, and before that, there was the Islam religion. The other religions are not shown in the picture of the ladder, and so you have to keep the picture of the cycle next to it. This is a study place. There would not be just one book in a study place. There are also maps in a study place. That worldly knowledge will not be of any use. People will be able to understand quickly with maps. These are your main maps. Everything is explained to you in so much depth, and yet those with stone intellects are unable to understand. Baba has explained. You must first of all explain the Trimurti at the exhibitions. That one is your Baba and this one is your Dada. How can he give you knowledge and the inheritance? Only the people of Bharat are to receive this inheritance. The Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul, establishes the three religions, Brahman, Deity and Warrior. He creates Brahmins through Brahma. This is the sacrificial fire, and it is called the sacrificial fire of the knowledge of Rudra. All the other sacrificial fires of the path of devotion begin later. Because, first of all, there is the worship of Shiv and then the worship of deities. There are no sacrificial fires at that time. It is later. They begin to have sacrificial fires. First of all, they worship deities and offer them flowers. You are not worthy of being worshipped at this time. Why do people go and offer akk flowers to Shiv? The father explains, all of you were thorns. Some became constant roses. Some became roses and others became like jasmine. Some even became akk flowers. Those who do not study fully became akk flowers. They are of no use at all. All the thorns are offered to shivbaba and they are then made into flowers. However, a variety of flowers is created. A garden has a variety of flowers. It is number wise amongst you too. Some will be seated on the heart throne and others will become something else. Only the father explains all of those things. No one else can explain them. The path of devotion, it's so complicated, and yet it doesn't have any knowledge at all. The deities existed in the golden age, but there isn't a single deity and the Iron Age. Therefore, God must surely have changed human beings into deities. The Father came and taught such actions that people learned them, imbibe divine virtues and became deities. What would those of other religions teach? They have to follow their founders down here. They simply give the knowledge of purity. When Christ comes, there are no Christians. All of them follow Christ down from up above. Baba has explained there are four main religions. The scripture of those who establish a religion is called a religious scripture. So, there are four main religions. All the rest are smaller religions which continue to grow. The Islamic religion has its own scriptures and the Buddhists have their own scripture. So, just the scriptures are religious scriptures. The Brahmin religion is of this type. Those people sing salutations to the Brahmins who are to become deities. Therefore, you have to explain to the worldly Brahmins that only the mouth-bone Brahmins created by God through Brahma are true Brahmins. They are not the children of Prajapita Brahma at all. They just call themselves Brahmins because they don't know the meaning of it. When they eat Brahma Bhojan, they recite verses in Sanskrit and praise the Brahma Bhojan. All of that praise is useless. You should ask them, how can you be Brahmins? Brahma, through whom God can create the world first, has to exist. We are the true Brahmins. Brahmins are portrayed with top knots. They don't show Brahmins in the variety form image. So, where do Brahmins come from? They call themselves Brahmins, but it is only when the Supreme Soul comes and creates the new creation through Brahma that you can be Brahmins. You Brahmins then became deities. Brahmins only exist at the confluence age. In the Iron Age, all are Shudras. Brahmins are praised a great deal. Baba explains all of these things to you. There is just Alpha and Beta and the rest is detail. You also have to explain about devotion. Baba says you are not a devotee. Are you? Baba never becomes angry, etc. The Father would give an explanation. Would he not? Whose name would be defamed in the children make mistakes, that of shivbaba. This is why Baba gives you children teachings for your own benefit. For instance, if this one makes a mistake, it is fixed in the drama for that one to rectify the mistake. There would be benefit in that too, because this one is the eldest child. Everything depends on this one and there won't be any loss through this one. When this one says do this, you should do it. Some benefit would then emerge even from a loss. There is no question of any loss. There is nothing but benefit in every aspect. Any loss is also fixed in the drama. Everyone continues to make mistakes. However, there definitely has to be some benefit in all circumstances. Because the Father is the benefactor, everyone has to be benefited. He grants salvation to everyone. It is now the time of settlement for everyone. There is a burden of sin on everyone's head. And so everyone's karmic accounts have to be settled. It doesn't take long for punishment to be given. Liberation and life is received in a second. Therefore, can the punishment for sins not be experienced in a second? As when people sacrifice themselves at Kashi and they shed their bodies. However, it isn't that they would go and meet shivbaba. No, their accounts of past sins are settled and then they begin afresh. No one can return home in the middle of the cycle. Although the knowledge is of just a second, You still have to study the shivbaba soul, who is the ocean of knowledge, comes and teaches you every day. Krishna is a bodily being and enters rebirth. Baba is beyond birth. Those who don't want to study will definitely create obstacles. There will definitely be obstacles in the sacrificial fire, and there will be assaults on innocent ones. All of those things are happening as they did in the previous cycle. Devils creates so much upheaval. They even tear up the pictures. Sometimes they don't hesitate to set fire to everything. What can we do? Internally, we understand it is destined. Externally, we have to report this to the police. Internally, we understand whatever took place in the previous cycle will take place again. There is no question of sorrow about this. When something goes missing from the laundry, there is of course a loss, but then another one would be made. Baba has already told you, when you hold exhibitions etc., have that place ensured for 8 days. If it is good person, he won't charge you anything. What does it matter if you don't have insurance? Very good new pictures would then be created. Multi-millions are earned at every step. Your every step and every second is very valuable. You became multi-millionaires and you are claiming the inheritance for 21 births from Baba, and so you should explain very well. There in heaven, you will have limitless wealth. There is no question of even counting it. Baba is making you so wealthy and happy. The income you receive is so great. The subjects too become so wealthy. This is your source of income for 21 births. This is the study place for becoming deities from human beings who is teaching you the father. Therefore, you shouldn't be careless about such a study. Acha, to the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, BapDada. The spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children says namaste and good morning to the spiritual father. Essence for the dharana. First point, constantly have the awareness there is benefit in everything in this beneficial age. We cannot experience any loss. Remain constantly carefree by considering there to be benefit in everything. Second point, in order to be constant roses, pay full attention to study. Don't be careless about study. Don't become an ak flower. Blessing, may you be loving to everyone and keep your record good by giving everyone regard. Explanation, to the extent that you give everyone regard, accordingly you keep your record good. To give regard to others means for oneself to keep a good record. Just as being a helper of the yajna means to receive help, in the same way, giving regard is receiving regard. Give once and claim a right to receive it many times. Generally, it is said, give love to the young ones and regard to the elders. But those who consider everyone to be their elder and give them regard are loved by everyone. For this, make the lesson of you first firm in every situation. Slogan, to remember the teachings you receive from BapDada at the appropriate time is to make intense effort. Om Shanti.